Making an Alexa device to work as media player inside Home Assistant is possible, and I'm going to do that now, and I want to be able to send custom text to my Alexa device for text-to-speech announcements.
Like or not?
I also want to be able to invoke some special sound effects from my Home Assistant automations, as example, an alarm if something that needs attention is happening, and I also want to automatically start some sequences like daily briefs or something, but that is kind of optional. What I don't want is any kind of paid subscription, as I want this whole Home Assistant Alexa integration to be entirely free. So, if you want to achieve the same, buckle your belts as we are starting. Here are the prerequisites. First, you need an Alexa-enabled device. It can be any kind of Echo device, Alexa-enabled Sonos speaker, or as in my case, a Fire HD tablet. If you don't have such device yet, and you want to check their current prices, you can use the affiliate links in the video description. Next, you need a working Home Assistant, preferably with add-on store. Using Home Assistant without add-on store is also an option, but some of the steps that I'm about to show are a bit different. For example, the HACS installation. If you need more info on the different Home Assistant installation types, join my upcoming webinar. Again, you can get the link from the video description and you can see it on your screen as well. I briefly mentioned HACS or Home Assistant Community Store, as this is also needed for today's Home Assistant Alexa integration, as it makes the Alexa Media Player so much easier to install. Also, all future updates are much easier. If you need more details and step-by-step HACS installation instructions, you can check my HACS article. And as you might guess, the link can be found in the video description. This is pretty much all that is needed, and here is how I installed HACS on a fast pace. I opened Home Assistant add-on store and I searched for advanced SSH and web terminal add-on and I installed it. After that, I opened the configuration tab and I set a password here. Then I saved the changes and I opened the info tab again and I started the add-on. Then I opened the add-on and I paste the following command, which will download the HACS and will install it for me. After the installation is ready, I'll restart my Home Assistant. After Home Assistant has started, I'll open the integration section of Home Assistant and I'll add a new integration and I'll search for HACS. I'll agree with everything here and I'll copy this code, then I'll open this GitHub link and I will authorize HACS. And I'm ready, I'm all set and I can open my HACS now if I click on this button. Again, if that was too fast, check my HACS article for all the details. Now when HACS is installed, the things get easier. Next step is to install Alexa Media Player custom integration using that HACS. Here is what I did. Inside HACS, I'll open integrations and I'll explore and download repositories. Then I'll search for Alexa Media Player and I'll select it. Then I'll hit download. I'll click on download again and I'll wait for HACS to install Alexa Media Player for me. I'll go back to see the pending restart message and I'll restart my Home Assistant. After Home Assistant has started, I'll open the integration section again and I'll add a new integration, but this time I'll search for Alexa Media Player. I'll select it. And after a while, I'll see this configuration window where I have to enter my Amazon credentials, that's my email and password, and my domain, in my case it's amazon.com, the local IP address of my Home Assistant, which is auto-populated, and 2-factor authentication code. These are the steps that I use to generate this code or key, and I'll put a link to these instructions in the video description. After I'm ready, I'll click submit and I'll confirm that OTP code is the same as in my authenticator app. All of this is done to prevent multiple re-logins of the integration later. Then I'll open this link and I have to re-authenticate again with my Amazon account. And after a while, the Alexa Media Player should be successfully installed in Home Assistant and I can see my Alexa devices listed here. Next step is to test if everything is working, and I'll start with testing a simple text-to-speech, or TTS for short. For that, I'll open the Home Assistant Developer Tools. Inside Home Assistant Developer Tools, I'll go to the Services tab and I'll search here for Notify Service and my Alexa device name. In my case, it's this one. As message, I can type anything I wish, for example, like or not, question mark. And as data, I'll type colon TTS and I'll call the service.
Like or not?
The same service can be called in any Home Assistant automation or script exactly the same way. For example, you can add another action to your existing automations, which will announce something using TTS, and your automations will now have a voice messages. Next thing that I want to test are the sound effects that are kind of embedded by Amazon, and they are quite a lot. I'm particularly interested in several alarms that I want to use. For example, one alarm for smoke detection and other for detected intruder. And also, I want some beeps. To test that, I'll open the developer tools again. I'll use media player, play media service, and I'll go to YAML mode. Then I'll use the script sample from the documentation of the integration, and I'll paste the YAML code inside. I'll format it in order to have the correct indentation. And when I'm ready, I'll call the service. As I already said, the sounds are a lot and you can get their IDs from the Amazon documentation. Link is in the video description. While I'm talking, I'll show you how you can invoke jokes using Home Assistant.
What kind of salad wears a diaper? Baby greens.
You can invoke several other sequences like commutes, jokes, and more. And exactly as with the TTS and sound effects, you can include that in any Home Assistant script or automation. Additionally, this Home Assistant media player integration allows so much more things, like running custom commands, which is just like saying voice commands directly to the Alexa device. But instead of talking, you'll be using Home Assistant scripts or automations. You can play music, you can set Echo Show backgrounds, you can interact with only the last called device, which is super handy. Running Alexa routines is also supported, arm and disarm Alexa guard mode is possible, and more. And hey, for those of you hungry for even more Home Assistant wisdom, I've got something special cooking up. It is a smart home glossary coming as a PDF file that you can download right now for free from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Let's dive into the world of Alexa and Home Assistant as they are now coolest they have ever been. Meanwhile, I'll catch you in the comment section of the video. I'm Kiryu and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!